place with Liam Ferry and James Taylor right behind him. Waters, your race leader, maintaining his position, but O'Brien is looking. He ranges up on the outside, going down the surface potential back straight, but then just has to pull back in line through the kart sports dip and will. Our leader with 10 laps to go, under plenty of pressure now, as it looks like O'Brien makes the move up the inside, going into the pit turn. I think he might have pulled it off as they work their way around the top of the circuit. It is O'Brien who in the fastkarts.com.au. Your new race leader from the Sydney driver, Matthew Waters, in the 13. They're still nose to tail, nothing between them now. Further back in the field, Robinson has been passed by Liam Ferry. So Ferry is starting to show some good speed here as Robinson, the current state champion in the KA3s, is under plenty of pressure now from James Taylor in the 25 kart. The Wollongong driver has put on a pretty good show this weekend in that 25 kart. He's had his share difficulties, but is fighting back well now in this final and looking to try and get himself into a top. Dean O'Brien from Dubbo leads the way in the 53 kart. O'Brien at the gap much. Driver gap to the counts behind extremely well. Liam Ferry in the 17 has pulled away slightly from Rob. Trying to adjust. Number 7 CRG Australia sponsored card. Robinson from Orange. One of the many contingent from that Midwest region. Developments are moving for their circuit. Orange, of course, one of the mainstays of karting across the country. And, of course, we look forward to up at the end of the year over there in Orange. So, Brian from Dubbo leads the way with Waters still in second place. Now Waters on that lap sets the fastest lap of the race. So Waters is pushing again. The 33.197 now is the fastest lap of this KA3 Senior Heavy Final. They work through the S's once again, and your leader is still the 53 of Dean O'Brien. O'Brien from Waters, then the gap back to Wrigley. It's still about 2.5 seconds between the front runners and third place Wrigley in the FA kart. Ferry from Newcastle, the trackside motorsport contingent, having a solid run in fourth place with Robinson from Orange rounding out the top five. Taylor, Brady Buchanan, Whitby and Lachlan Chancellor, the first of the Canberra drivers. Then it's back to Jamie Prendergast, who rounds out the top 10. As we're down to only 4 laps remaining now. A full call of the card. O'Brien leads Waters, Wrigley, Ferry, Robinson, Taylor, Brady Buchanan, Whitby, Lachlan Chancellor, then it's Prendergast, Hayden Buchanan, Thomas McDonald, McKay, Inman, Edwards, Downton, and Harradine is the final card still out there running. Dylan Shepherd in the 43 having troubles on lap number 4, and Jackie Isrin on car lap number 7 are the only karts out of this final. Your leaders, O'Brien and Waters, with 3 laps, less than that now as they head around the top of the circuit. They work their way off the top turns and into the service potential back straight through the Dunlop Kart Sport dip and into the S's once again. It's O'Brien, your race leader. O'Brien withstanding the pressure from Waters in the 13. O'Brien now sets the fastest lap of the race with a 33.037. As we have karts off, that's Trevor Whitby in the 32. Whitby. Unfortunately, the Griffith driver, Cart, is going to take no through the S's. White flag is out now for Dean O'Brien, who leads the way. Will Dubbo take first blood in the New South Wales Karting Championships? It's Dean O'Brien who leads the way at the moment as O'Brien works around the top of the circuit. His pressure now being applied by the 13 kart in. The final turns now. It's Dean O'Brien. Place Matthew Waters. Luke Wrigley a solid drive to third. Liam Ferry has held off the defending champion in Brett Robinson for fifth. James Taylor in the 25 finishes in sixth place. Lachlan Chancellor, the first of the Canberra drivers home, in seventh place. Brady Buchanan in eighth. Jamie Prenick Buchanan in tenth. Rounding out 11 through 15. Downton and Reese Harradine, unfortunately, in the 9 card, having the final place on. Driving by Dubbo's Dean O'Brien to take the victory in KA3 Senior Heavies.
Karting. Arrive and drive on the best events or the kids' birthday parties. Go to powerkarts.com.au.
Don't forget to check out all the live timing available on Race Monitor. You can download the Race Monitor app or for your Windows, Android and Apple phones, as well as for your PC, your iPad and tablet. You can see all the timing and scoring live from the New South Wales Karting Championships this weekend in Canberra. Check out the App Store.
To satisfy, it's the Ruers Guarantee. Ruersconstructions.com.au.
At Service Potential, we specialise in collaborating with companies to identify and achieve IT efficiencies to create a strategic business asset. By transforming an organisation's IT governance, IT service management and IT service operations, we support organisations to move away from reactive and unreliable IT functions. 35 599 568 or email matt@servicepotential.com.au. Service Potential, major sponsor for the Canberra Cup 2016. Watts Communications is a family-owned and operated business established in Canberra for over 25 years. They are your one-stop shop for all of your two-way radio, UHF, CB radio, GPS navigation and vehicle tracking needs. Our showroom features a large range of GPS and radio equipment on display, and we maintain a fully equipped electronics and installation workshop. Contact Watts, Unit 1, 68 to 70 Kembla Street, Fishwick, or call them on 6280 6416.
The KA4 Junior Light Final heads out onto the circuit now. The 47 of Thomas Sargent sits on the pole in the Tegra Australia Cosmic. So the Grenfell driver will lead them to the green light. The 18 of Zach Crichton from Sydney in the CRG St George Kart Centre, number 18, is on the outside of the front row. Travis Wharton in the 82 will start out of position number 3, whilst Cody Bircher from Orange will start out of position number 4. Jaden Pope in the 24, Oscar Priest is in the 56. He's the first of the Newcastle contingent in this race. Then 7th place is the 88 of Christopher Polis. Cameron Ward's in the 57. Braden Everence in the 40. Suslan Harlow is in the 77, makes up the top 10. Angus Wallace is in 11th position in the 7 kart. Then it's Mia Bolton in the 23. Blake Motby in the 27. Tommy Harradine's in the 62. Russell Mayo's in the 17. Zach Hurd's in the 48. Thomas Heyman in the 30. Ryan Hughes is in the 51. The 15 is Ricardo Diesti. Bailey Sweeney's in the 3. Jordan Mazzaroli's in the 61. We're away and racing. Sargent gets a great start off the inside of the front row. It's Travis Wharton, the state champion, who is in second position off the start. It looks like the front runners have got through all right. One cart off the circuit. There is the 60. Harradine, unfortunately, not going to take part in this final. It's Sargent leading the way from Wharton, the defending champion in the KA4s. He runs the blue plates on his kart 82, brought to you by Jamrock Racing and Chill Out. It's the Arrow Chassis that is sitting behind our leader in Thomas Sargent. Zach Crichton now runs in third position as he's behind, being put there by the 24, the Tony Kart of Jaden Pope. As Sargent just getting out of shape there and loses the lead. So Sargent drops down to fifth position, in fact, as Crichton is your leader. So Wharton in second spot still. Then it's back to Pope and Bircher from Orange in the 36. So Crichton now, fastest lap of the race, a 34.034, as they have 17 laps remaining. More troubles at the top of the circuit, the back in the pack. But our leader, Zach Crichton, in the 18 kart, works his way across the start-finish line to complete lap number 3. Wharton with Pope in the Tony Kart number 24, right behind him. Then you have Cody Bircher in the red speed, the Bircher EFI entry. Now Sargent back in fifth has lost a bit of ground on that lap and he's not more. So perhaps there is something more adrift on the 47 kart than it might have appeared. Sixth position with Everett in the 40. Then it's back to Suslin Harlow. He's moving forward. Got past Oscar Priest now in the 56. Angus Wallace rounding out the top 10. Our leader is still Zach Crichton in the CRG from the St. George Kart Centre, based for racing for the North Shore Karting Club and putting a good run together at this point of the race. Our leaders head through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. Up over the rise, and Wharton in the 82, running in second. Still Pope unable to try and challenge him. Jaden Pope, another of the North Shore Kart Club members, with a Southern Tyre and Karting World sponsorship on that Tony Kart. Further back, we've got, a heavy contact further back in the pack. Four karts involved. Two karts look like they're bogged down the bottom there. It's the 61 kart. Has managed to extract himself there. Diesti in the 15. 61 is Mazzaroli. I think Young Varley is... certainly Young Varley is beached and perhaps the Diesti cart will no longer take any further run in this final. So as our leaders work their way through the pit turn once again and up the pit straight, Zach Crichton in the... in place, Wharton continues to consolidate his position as he pulls away from Pope now. Bircher is in fourth. Poulos has made the pass on Sargent. So Sargent is also coming under pressure from the 77 of Suslin Harlow. We've got a cart off into the S's that time. And that looks like it could be Young... it's looking like it's Cody Bircher, the orange driver in the Bircher EFI kart number 36. So Bircher, unfortunately, losing it, going down in pain. Zach Crichton is working his way through the final turn with 12 laps remaining. Now the 44 is looking like he'll be the first kart to go a lap down. Lachlan Strickland in the 44 will receive the blue with red diagonals, which will indicate that he's about to be lapped and he's asked track. So that will be a few laps away now as Strickland comes across the line as the leaders are heading into the S's here at Circuit Mark Webber in Canberra. The leader comes across the line now. His lead is out to 1.016 seconds. Wharton in the 8. Aiden Pope in the 24. Polis in the 88. In the 70. Cart. Braden Everett in the 40. Oscar Priest. Pressure now from the 57 of Cameron Ward. So Ward trying to make a move of the 40 of Braden Everett. So Crichton well in control here in this, the final of the KA4 Junior Lights as they work their way through the dip. Wharton doesn't seem to have the pace of Crichton. So Crichton is seat with 9 laps to go. Wharton adjusting his helmet as he heads up into the pit turn that time. Pope has closed in on him now, and Pope is really starting to put the pressure on. That last lap, he was just on 0.1 of a second faster than the second place runner. So the 82 of Wharton now under pressure from the 24 of Pope as they come through the Dunlop Kart Sports step and head towards the S's once again. The 24 of Jaden Pope works his way through the start-finish line once again. Wharton in second, Pope in third. Then it's Sargent in fourth position with Suslan Harlow right behind him. It looks like Sargent, who had some problems in Heat 3, those engine problems are still with him as he tries now to maintain that fourth place position with Suslan Harlow in the PCR kart right behind him. Oh, more dramas down there as the 40 kart of Braden Everett rejoins the circuit, and you have to wonder if that is a set of brakes that might be at a problem here. So Braden Everett getting his car back up to speed. He's not pumping the brake pedal, so maybe that was just a loss of control there. He got us some help, I'm being advised, in the background. So Crichton, Wharton, Pope, Sargent, Suslan Harlow, Paulus, Wallace, Bolton, Priest and Ward now make up your top 10 as the leaders have less than 6 laps to travel. Crichton with a 2-second advantage at the front of the field. So Crichton doing a good job out in front. Second place Wharton, then it's Pope trying still to again, putting the pressure on this time. He goes into the S's and a nice pass made by Jaden Pope from North Shore Kart Club in Sydney. The Tony Kart with the Southern Tyres Karting World sponsorship is now up into the second position. Wharton in the 82 shuffled back to third. It's Jamrock Racing, the chill out entry that is the defending champion in the Arrow X3. In third place with Pope starting to pull away slightly. Sargent still fighting on for fourth position, while Suslan Harlow in fifth in the 77 through the final turn now. Further back to North Shore Karting Club, that's another of the Kart Schools Australia entries, with the first to the Grenfell, or the second past Oscar Castle, back ahead of Angus Wallace with Cameron Ward still rounding out the 10. Wharton back in front of Pope now as he makes the pass, and Wharton back into second position. Crichton with three laps left to run, as Sargent is still in fourth position. Suslan Harlow looks like he's lost a bit of ground to Sargent there. He's back 1.3 seconds behind the 47. And in fact, if anything, the Sargent cart looks like it's coming good towards the end of the run, as Wharton Pope now will have the 47, the hard-charging Tegra Australia Cosmic cart of Thomas Sargent in the 47, closing up to make a real battle of this, as Pope goes to the inside into the kink this time. And Pope, can he hold on for second place? Thomas Sargent is up there right on the back of this battle now. So Wharton Pope, Sargent all mixing it up as they work their way around the top of the circuit once again. What can Sargent do? He goes to the outside of Pope through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. Pope has Sargent up the inside, and Sargent gets up over the top of Wharton. They both rejoin. Are the karts okay? They, well, haven't really changed position, but Crichton, under the white flag now, has got a sizable lead. Wharton is in second place. Wharton in second, then it's Sargent, followed by Pope, as they work their way around the top of the circuit. And Sargent runs wide coming off the top turn. What will Pope try to do? Pope's trying to run it down the inside of the track as they head through the kart sports dip and up into the S's. And Pope and Sargent come together. They're both off and just managed to miss the Bircher kart that was off the circuit. As the checker flag waves, Crichton takes the victory. Wharton comes home in second. Third place will go to Jackson Suslan Harlow, with Mia Bolton up into fourth. Polis in fifth. Pope in sixth. Then it's Wallace, Priest, Ward, and rounding out the ten, Ryan Hughes. Further back then to Hurd, Motby, Mayo, Everett, then Hughes rounds out the 15. Unfortunately, Sargent, Morris, Sweeney and Morris coming through now, so they will be classified as finishers. It was a dominating drive by the 18 of Zach Crichton from the new car, from the North Shore Karting Club, with the CRG St. George Kart sponsorship there, taking the win in the end by 4 seconds from Travis Wharton and Jackson Suslan Harlow. It was North Shore Karting Club sweeping the top three in this, the KA4 Junior Lights Final.
Photos from the weekend, they have the $50 CD deal. It includes action shots, personal shots, group start and finish photos. These quality images can be viewed at any time over the weekend on the large screen at the Cooper's Photography Display. Now, you can purchase the images and you can collect them after your final race, or for an additional $5, they can be sent directly to you. Go and see Nikki down there at Cooper's Photography for more details.
Angelo and his team at Diafora Painting Group have over 20 years' experience in painting new homes and commercial buildings, inside and out. Check out our clubhouse and see an example of Diafora's work, including the painted flooring systems, a great idea for garages and rumpus rooms. Diafora also specialise in repainting existing homes and buildings. Call Angelo at Diafora Painting Group on 0415 809 990 and tell him the Canberra Kart Racing Club sent you.
The 2016 New South Wales Kart Championships are brought to you by Dunlop Kart Sport. For the vision, the goal and the results of absolute success, then you must try Dunlop tyres. You see the new evolution in intelligent karting tyre technology. Experience the difference. Shop online at dk17.com.au. Dunlop Kart Sport, proud sponsors of the New South Wales Kart Championships.
Jennifer Nipperis from Aussie. Call her on 0414 243 726. For a home loan health check, financing inquiries, debit inquiries, home loan purchases or investment purchases. If you are thinking of home improvements or renovations, it's free to have an appointment to look at your needs. Call Jennifer on 0414 243 726.
1300 kilonewton centrifugal force, infrared remote control.
How does he do it?
24.5 kilowatt diesel motor.
He doesn't just know how to operate every piece of Kennard's high gear we get in, but also its service details, its safety checks. I don't know.
It's as if he can hypnotise each piece.
Give me two passes with sauce. Coffee white with one, bun with icing. No, pink icing.
Yep, no worries, Terry.
I think we should get a professional to fix it.
If I could just get it started.
Leave your car in the capable hands of the mechanics at Mechanical Care, specialising in logbook servicing, brakes, tyres, steering, suspension and ACT in New South Wales Regio and gas renewals. Plus, you can get a lift back to your work or borrow a car or ute for the day or shop at Westfield while your car is serviced. For family-friendly services, call Mechanical Care Belconnen on 6251 4883.
What a drag. No, not you, mate. Ordinary fuel's clogging up your engine with filthy dirt. It's like lugging around one of these. New BP Ultimate eats up the dirt like 1,000 ravenous piranhas. It busts dirt in just 2 tanks. It's designed for a smoother drive and more kilometres per tank. Go new BP Ultimate.
Power Kart Raceway, world-class indoor karting. Arrive and drive on the best F1-style go-kart track in Australia. Perfect for your company's next team-building events or the kids' birthday parties. Go to powercarts.com.au.
Don't forget to check out all the live timing available on Race Monitor. You can download the Race Monitor app or for your Windows, Android and Apple phones, as well as for your PC, your iPad and tablet. You can see.
So the KA3 senior lights heading out for their final. Just a reminder, thanks to our great major sponsor of the New South Wales Dunlop Kart Sports Championship, the major draw for 5 sets of Dunlop tyres will take place at the trophy presentation after the finals this afternoon. You must be in attendance to be able to claim your prize. So thanks to Dunlop Kart Sport for their support of the 2016 New South Wales Karting Championships. Also like to thank CRG. They have got random prize draws going on at the moment on the grid before each of these finals. And then at Manning Valley will be the major prizes of a senior and junior chassis for competitors who have participated throughout the 2016 New South Wales Karting Championships. Now, Beck Connell in the 29 will start from the pole. Cody Garland's in the 41, Sarah Collins in the 5, Jeffrey Raleigh's in the 7, Anthony Wishkiss in the 83, the 27 is Thomas Davies. 81 is James O'Malley. Sean Shibutary's in the 9. Bradley Newman in the 10. Whitmore, Dunbar, Inwood, Whitty, Wells and Wilson round out the runners here in the senior light final. They head through the pit turn and up the pit straight. All single file now as Connell, who has put in a solid performance throughout this weekend's racing. She dominated heat number one by 4.5 seconds. In heat two, it was a much closer affair with only a 0.2 of a second gap. And then in heat three, it was Cody Garland who got the better of Connell to take the victory. But Connell is well out in front. Shibutary in the 9, the local Canberra driver, is pushing hard. He's up to 6th place already, with Cody Garland in the 41 back to 5th place. So Shibutary has got the local knowledge here. We'll see how he progresses in that 9 kart. Sarah Collins in the 5 is putting in a good solid performance here, with Jeffrey Raleigh behind in the 7. So Raleigh in that seven cut, looks to make a move on Collins as he comes out of the final turn now. They head across the start-finish line and rally under plenty of pressure from behind, as well as Thomas Davies is right on his back bumper. Connell sets the fastest lap of the race. She sets the marker at 32.985 as they work their way down the service potential back straight. Whilst the Shane Piper race engine-powered arrow of Beck Connell is pulling away at the front of the field. Rally makes the move for second now on Sarah Collins in the five. Rally in the seven and Sarah Collins in the five, battling it out as they come across the start-finish line. It is the North Shore Karting Club driving her in the five of Sarah Collins, who now follows the CRG in the runaway motorsports entry of Jeffrey Raleigh. So the Lithgow driver in the seven, now up into second position. Collins shuffled back to third as Collins now works her way up the inside of Raleigh again, as the 27 also thought about following Collins through. And Davies now will lose a spot as Garland tried to make the move, and the Perta cart has got a broken left hand tie rod end. So the tie rod broken on the the tie rod looked like it was broken on the left hand front of the 24 cart, and that's unfortunate for the 27 cart. And Davies pulls into the pits. So Connell, Sarah Collins, rally. Then it's back to Sean Shibuteri. So the Tony card of Shibuteri, number 9, is up into fourth. Wishkiss in the 83, running in fifth position. Then it's O'Malley. Now O'Malley from Wagga in the Tuma Toyota kart, number 81. He had a DNF in heat one, which has put him well down the pack, but he has had great speed as Wishkiss right in front of him locks up in front of the Dunlop Kart Sports dip, and O'Malley does well not to hit him. Garland has fallen back into the pack and is right on the back bumper of O'Malley now, who tries to make a move on the 83 but just can't get the pass done. It's Connell out in front by 3.3 seconds, leading this one in the 29 card. Second place is the 5 of Sarah Collins. She skipped away slightly from the 7 of Jeffrey Raleigh, who's got Sean Shibuteri right on his back bumper. Wishkiss now, has got a new challenger, because going into the braking zone, James O'Malley in the 81 just got a little bit squirrely there and has opened the door, and straight through went Cody Garland in that 41 card. Cody Garland from Manning Valley in the wholesale D's and Z entry will be looking to get himself up better than sixth position now as we work down the service potential back straight. Third place is now Sean Shibuteri as Garland up the inside of Wishkiss. So Wishkiss in the 40, in the 83, shuffled back to fifth position as Garland is on a charge. Rally in the 7 cart, the runaway motorsports CRG will be the next cart that he is trying to pick off. Beck Connell well out in front. Collins with a solid drive. Then it's Shibuteri in the 9, running in third. And now we watch this battle between Jeffrey Raleigh from Lithgow and Manning Valley's Cody Garland. Garland up the inside of Raleigh, and he makes the pass. So Raleigh shuffled back to fourth as our leader across the start finish line. Beck Connell driving extremely well out in front by 3.7 seconds. Then it's Sarah Collins back in second position, running in fifth. Collins today has had a bit of an up and down result throughout the weekend, but has come good when it matters here in the final and holds a solid second place, with Sean Shibuteri trying to close down the gap, which sits at just over half a second. But he now has the problem of the hard-charging Cody Garland, who won Heat 3 earlier today, looking to make the move for the podium spot. Garland in the 41 just goes fastest on the circuit, a 32.596. Cody Garland in the 41, fastest man out on the track, as we've reached half race distance now. And Shibuteri looks up the inside to see Garland, and Garland with a good lunge. Also making the lunge into the S's that time is O'Malley. And O'Malley will take now fifth spot away from Jeffrey Riley, who looks like he's just falling a bit in performance, as Wishkist's Newman from Bathurst and Newcastle's Melissa Whitmore all are trying to hunt down the 7 cart from Lithgow. Our leader doing it comfortably out in front is Beck Connell. The Shane Piper race engine's arrow well out in front as she comes across the line to complete lap number 12. Behind her, Sarah Collins, under some pressure now from Cody Garland. Garland heads through the pit turn and looks like he's close enough now to consider a move either around the top turns or definitely into the S's at the bottom of the hill. They head down the service potential back straight, and it is still Collins, Garland and Shibuteri battling it out for second position. Garland too far back to make the pass as they go through the S's, though. He closes that gap up to about a foot. Cody Garland so quick through the tighter parts of the circuit. Collins under plenty of pressure now in the 5. Sarah Collins will look to try and hold onto that spot, but 7 laps is a long time to try and keep the hard charging 41 from Manning Valley at bay. The wholesale diesel cart tried to go down the inside of Collins. Collins had him covered off that time, and Collins in the 5 maintains second position with 6 laps to run. Shibuteri just quietly sitting back there in fourth position. If anything was to go wrong with some of this battling up front, he's in the catbird seat to find himself back on the podium. He hasn't had the weekend he'd like to have this weekend, but right now, oh, Garland puts his cart over to the outside of the track, just got a wheel into the dirt, and was very lucky to hold onto it, as Shibuteri at the same time was trying to get side by side with him. So Shibuteri has lost a bit of ground. He looks over his shoulder. O'Malley is a ways back. So he'll just have to concentrate now to close up the ground he'd lost. With O'Connell, Collins, Garland, Shibuteri, O'Malley, Newman, Riley, Wishkist, Whitmore and Jared Whitty from Griffith up now into 10th position. Oh, Garland and... Garland, oh, again into the back of Collins. No positions change, but it did allow Sean Shibuteri to close in once again. So Shibuteri heads up onto the pit straight in a definite chance for a battle with the second position. So Collins, no, Garland makes the move coming off the top turns now. So Garland is your new second place runner. Collins, can she defend now Shibuteri and also O'Malley, who has driven himself up into this battle? The top, well, third, fourth and fifth all nose to tail as they come across the start finish line with just 3 laps left to run. So Beck Connell well out in front. Her gap 5.4 seconds. She had a 5-second victory in Heat 1 on Saturday, and she leads by that amount once again here in the final on Sunday. Cody Garland in second position. Then it's Sarah Collins in the red speed. Where's Shibuteri in the Tony cart behind her? O'Malley is back there in the Tumut Toyota Kart 81. He's still looking for an opportunity to get himself up into fourth position, but Shibuteri is a wily driver, plenty of experience here at Canberra, and won't want to give up that spot. The white flag is out. Beck Connell starts her final circuit here at Circuit Mark Webber in this, the KA3 Senior Lights final, as Cody Garland's in second, Sarah Collins, Shibuteri and O'Malley. As, oh, a spectacular incident. A wheel has been lost by one of the backmarkers right in front of the race leader. That looks like it's Catherine Wilson. Beck Connell will take the victory ahead of Cody Garland as Cody Garland comes across the line. Sarah Collins will take third. Shibateri's in fourth. Fifth place goes to O'Malley. Then sixth place back there to O'Newman, Riley, Whitmore. Wishkiss holds on from Whitby, rounding out the top 10. Dunbar, Harrison, Inwood, and John Wells round out the runners here in the KA3 senior final. Unfortunately for Catherine Wilson, with just over a lap to go, a rear tyre has come off the cart going through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip, and she's hit the tyres quite heavily in front of this jam-packed grandstand here at Circuit Mark Webber.
The Canberra Kart Racing Club continues its championship season on the 29th of May with the Canberra Open Sprint, fourth round of the club championship. On the 5th of June, it's the Southern Stars Series in Griffith. Then it's off to Canberra for the 25th and 26th of June when the Southern Stars head to Circuit Mark Webber. On the 9th and 10th of July, it's over to Grenfell for the Bob Hine Memorial and Festival of the Kids, round 7 of the Canberra Kart Racing Club Championship. The Midwinter Sprint is on the 31st of July. Check the Canberra Kart Racing Club website for the 27th and 28th of August, when the Taz O'Hara meeting is to be confirmed. On the 18th of September, the 10th round of the championship will roar into action. On the 16th of October will be round 11, with round 12 culminating in the Service Potential Canberra Cup on the 19th and 20th of November. We hope you can join us back here at Circuit Mark Webber throughout season 2016.
BP Queanbeyan is a proud sponsor of the Canberra Kart Racing Club. They provide control fuel for all the club's major events and offer petrol, diesel and gas for your road car as well. With a Wild Bean Cafe, LPG bottled gas, car wash and more, BP Queanbeyan is your one-stop shop. BP Queanbeyan on Yass Road, it's just on the right as you go under sponsors of the Canberra Kart Racing Club.
The Canberra Kart Racing Club would like to thank us once again here at the Circuit Mark Webber. If you're interested in getting photos from the weekend, they have the $50 CD deal. It includes action shots, personal shots, group start and finish photos. These quality images can be viewed at any time over the weekend on the large screen at the Cooper's Photography Display. Now you can purchase the images and you can collect them after your final race, or for an additional $5 they can be sent directly to you. Go and see Nikki down there at Cooper's Photography for more details.
Angelo and his team at Diafora Painting Group have over 20 years experience in painting new homes and commercial buildings, inside and out. Check out our clubhouse and see an example of Diafora's work, including the painted flooring systems, a great idea for garages and rumpus rooms. Diafora also specialise in repainting existing homes and buildings. Call Angelo at Diafora Painting Group on 09990. Club sent you.
The 2016 New South Wales Kart Championships are brought to you by Dunlop Kart Sport. And the results of absolute success, then you must try Dunlop. New evolution in intelligent karting tyre technology.
The 95 of William Seal has qualified on the pole here for the final of the Cadet 12s in the Castrol Edge Esprit. The 69 is Cody Mains Ruddy. The 71 is Jonathan Markison. The 16 is Adrian Hayek. 57, is Reece Smith, the 18. Kent Fiese on. Then it's Josh Sargent in the 74. Josh Haynes in the 19. Kylie Cotters in the 17. Bailey Hazard's in the 55. Back then to the 28 of Beau Prosnetti. Then it's Joel Strode in the 65. Zach Bates in the 24. The 2 is Cooper Griffiths. 99 is Jack Childs. The 7 is Lachlan Campbell. Tom Drain's in the 59. Harrison Mitchell in the 11. The 5's Luke Thompson. The pole, the fastest qualifier is Samuel Christensen. He's coming out of position 21. Riley Rouse is the 66. The 36 is Shannon Mortlock. And all 24, Thomas McTighe makes the numbers here in this 24 starters for the Cadet 12s final. So William Seal has been able to put together a consistent weekend. It was Reece Smith who won Heat 1 from Josh Sargent and Adrian Hayek, with Seal finishing in 4th place. In Heat 2, it was Mains Ruddy winning Heat 2 from Sargent, Seal, Markison and Fiese on. Then in Heat 3, earlier today, it was Smith, Seal, Markison, Hayek and Mains Ruddy. So we look for an interesting final, to say the least. Seal will be on the outside of the track, but that is the pole line as they go into the kink and into then the pit turns. So Seal and Mains Ruddy. Very even start. Mains Ruddy's trying to stay tough on the inside. They're side by side, and Mains Ruddy will take the lead as they head up the pit straight for the first time. Mains Ruddy, Seal are your leaders as they work their way around. Seal makes the move up the inside of the top turns. Mains Ruddy immediately trying to come back at him, but William Seal will lead the way into the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. And up over the rise, Mains Ruddy and Seal, nose to tail. Back there in the 16 is Adrian Hayek. So it's Lithgow from two Wollongong drivers in the lead of this first lap of the Cadet 12s final. As they work their way back up the pit straight once again, Markison is in fourth, Smith already up into fifth, Haynes is in the 19 kart running in sixth place, Fiete on, then it's Sargent, Hazard and Prosnesti in the top 10. So watch for the 37, also the 65 is a kart off in going through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. That was the 7 kart of Lachlan Campbell. So as our leaders work their way through, Seal, Mains, Ruddy and Hayek, Smith, Markison, Haynes make up your top five. But it's the top three who are all nose to tail at the moment. As they work their way around the top of the circuit, down the service potential back straight, Seal with Mains, Ruddy. Up the inside of Mains, Ruddy into the S's. That time was Hayek, and Hayek will take second position. Seal from Lithgow, Hayek from Sydney, and Mains Ruddy from Wollongong work their way through the pit turn. And now Mains Ruddy has got Reece Smith from Wagga right on his back bumper. So a mixture of carts and clubs as Mains Ruddy is shuffled back to fourth place now, as Reece Smith in the 57 makes the pass coming off the top turns. So Reece Smith working his way back up through the S's behind Adrian Hayek from the CRG Tilton Interiors sponsored number 16 out of Sydney. The 16 kart is based, and they head along that back straight with Smith closing in. Smith goes immediately to the inside on the top turns, and Smith, without any trouble at all, makes the move up into second place. So the PCR of Reece Smith, kart number 57, is second. Now Mains Ruddy looking to try and make the move on Hayek. Just couldn't get it done going into the S's that time. But Seal will have some pressure applied to his back bumper soon, because Reece Smith is the fastest kart on the circuit with a 35.620 his lap time. The Wagga driver works his way around the top of the circuit once again. A kart length up there is the difference between first and second. They are skipping away now from Hayek. Mains Ruddy's coming under fire from Markison. Jonathan Markison, another of the Wollongong runners, and he is right in the wheel tracks now of Cody Mains Ruddy. So then you go back to the 19 of Josh Haynes, the first of the Canberra drivers out there on circuit, Mark Webber. He's in the Red Speed, the Cowpart Raceway Red Speed, as we've got a spinner on the pit straight. Looks like it's the 18 cut of Kent Fiet-Aion. Fiet-Aion was the winner here in the shakedown meeting, but just hasn't had that speed that he showed on that occasion. Seal, Smith, Hayek is your top three, with Mains Ruddy, Markison, and then Josh Haynes all looming up to form a fairly big battle there. Sargent is in amongst the Presnetti, Cotter, Hazard, and Sands battle. Dirt, plenty of dirt being kicked up there as they are mixing it up in what is effectively a battle for 8th, 9th, 10th positions. As our leader, well, Smith makes a big move round the outside, and Reece Smith will take the lead. Seal went to go back on him on the inside, but Smith was able to hold. Oh, round goes Hayek. Adrian Hayek in the 16 cart gathers it back up, and he is trying to get himself up and running once again, but is losing a lot of track position. So Reece Smith in the 57 leads the way, as the 95 William Seal in second. Mains Ruddy's back up to third, as Markison is back there in fourth position. Further back then to Josh Haynes in fifth, then at Sargent in sixth place. The battle behind is done with Hayek out of the picture. It means Hazard, Cotter, Thompson, Sands, and then I think Bates is also involved in that battle as well. So our fastest qualifier yesterday, Samuel Christensen, has worked his way up into 11th position now, after coming out of about 22nd, 21st or 22nd now from this start of the final. So that has been a pretty tough drive by Samuel Christensen from the Brennan IT Tony Kart number 37. Our leaders at half race distance is Reece Smith. William Seal runs in second position. Cody's main Ruddy is in third. Markison, Haynes, Sargent, Hazard, Thomas, Cotter, Christensen rounds out the 10 now as he gets past Noah Sands. 11 through 15 is Sands, Griffiths, Childs, Bates, and Prosnetti. Then it's Campbell, Mitchell, Drain, Strode, Mortlock, Hayek, Rouse, Fiet-Aion, and McTighe rounding out the runners. All 24 still out there on the circuit at the moment, as Hayek gets two more spots now going through the final turns, gets past Strode and also the 36. The 36 of Shannon Mortlock. So Hayek trying to recover as the battle at the front of the field continues, as William Seal again makes the move for the lead. Smith and Seal side by side at the line. Seal is scored as the leader, but it's Smith who... Oh, Seal misses the turn and then comes back out in, what's that, fourth place. So William Seal, who was leading at the start-finish line, now is back into fourth position as he was unable to get through the pit turn. And what a race we are seeing in the Cadet 12s final. First round of the New South Wales Kart Championships here at Circuit Mark Webber in Canberra. They work their way through the final turn now. Smith is your race leader. Cody Mains Ruddy is back up into second position. Following him is Markison, then it's Seal, Haynes, and Sargent, as the top five carts are all separated by 1.2 seconds. And Reece Smith, fastest cart on the circuit, has been able to just skip away slightly from Mains Ruddy, who's now got Markison up the inside for second place. Markison makes the move, opens the door, and Seal, with a brave move up the inside of the left-hander, is able to take the spot. So Seal works his way back to third now as Mains Ruddy and Josh Haynes round out the top five. Our leader is still Reece Smith. Reece Smith from Wagga in the Scuderia PCR, car 57. Leads now by over half a second. Back to Markison and Seal. Markison from Wollongong in the diesel racing. Number 71, Seal back there from Lithgow in the Castrol Edge sponsored kart. Now Mains Ruddy under pressure from the Canberra driver in Josh Haynes. Just Haynes not able to get the pass done going into the pit turn that time. Smith controlling this race now, half a second lead, the most that he's had for this final. And with five laps, or less than five laps to run, you think Smith would be able to hold on. Seal makes the move now on Markison. So Seal back up to second position as Haynes again tries to go up the inside of Mains Ruddy. Mains Ruddy again trying to hold off, but this time Josh Haynes in the red speed. Power Kart Raceways number 19 has grabbed fourth position. Now what can Haynes do? Now he's got clear track in front of him. Is he able to bridge the gap with less than four laps to run? No, he can't, because Mains Ruddy straight up the inside round the top turns and will take back fourth position. Seal in second, Magnuson in third. They head into the S's now, nose to tail. But no one able to change positions there. Smith extending his lead at the front of the field. Haynes makes the pass coming off the final turn, back in front of Mains Ruddy once again for fourth place. This time it looks like he got the pass done a bit cleaner and has opened up a bit of breathing space over Cody Mains Ruddy. Sargent still runs in sixth, Thomas in seventh, Christensen up to eighth position. A great drive by the number 37, Brennan IT, Tony Cart. And he is really driving this race. It would probably be the drive of the race as the 37 tries to make the move now on the 5 of Luke Thomas. So Christensen and Thomas nose to tail as they come onto the start finish straight with two laps to go. Christensen lost a bit of ground that time, so Kyle Cotter is having a run at him in the pit turn, but I think Christensen has been able to hold him off for the moment. Our leader heads down into the S's for the penultimate time. White flag at the ready. Reece Smith in the 57, leading the way from William Seal and Jonathan Markison. Seal and Markison second and third. It looks like Seal has just skipped away slightly. Hayes now ahead of Sargent, so Mains Ruddy has lost another spot there. I didn't see where that occurred, but our leader is the 57 of Reece Smith from Wagga, the Scuderia PCR Australia. Kart number 57 from Wagga heads through the final turns and looks to take the victory. It's Reece Smith who takes the win. Second is William Seal. Third is Jonathan Markison. Then it's Josh Haynes. Sargent comes home in fifth. Mains Ruddy is back there in six. He looks disappointed with that result. At the line, Thomas holds off the charging Kyle Cotter. Christensen up into ninth position after starting out of about 21st place. That was a good run. Bailey Hazard was next, rounding out the top 10. 11 through 15, Child Hayek. Then it's Griffiths, Mitchell and Noah Sands. Then 16 through 20, Bates, Drain, Campbell, Prosnetti, Mortlock, Kent Fairseon, Rouse and Thomas rounding out the 23 finishes, with Joel Strode unfortunately off the circuit on lap 13.
with Terry's finger. They say it can perform miracles.
Well, go on. Test it out.
Terry, the drain in Building 3 is blocked. We can't lift the glass sheets and we've got nothing to get those pipes cut by 2 p.m.
Leave it with me.
Oh. Yep, right.
Right, pipe camera, glass lifter, concrete saw.
It's a finger phenomenon. I could kiss it. Canox making jobs easy.
Anyone sitting or standing and bouncing on the fence, please get off the fence now. Please sit in the grandstand to watch the races as the officials can't see the corners if you're standing up on the fences. So, as we get set for the tag 125 restricted heavies out on the circuit, it's Zach Phelan in the 49 that... They're a solid performance throughout the heat. He'll sit. Had an up and down weekend so far, but starts on the outside of the front row in cart number 10. Daniel Sirigello in the 16. Simon Kendrick was the fastest qualifier. He'll start out of position number 4. Jamie Fields in the 5. Philip Borgs in the 71. Jamie Blewett is in the 12. Graham Stevens in the 24. The 32 is Philip Bowen. The 10 starters all set to go here in the tag 125 restricted final. So, about set for a start. Looking for what should be a good race. A very slow start. We've seen in the heat races so far this weekend... It was Zach Phelan who won a very interesting heat one from Seymour and Sirigello. In heat two, it was Kendrick, Seymour and Phelan. And as we go racing, Phelan gets the jump here in the final. As Phelan in the 49 leads the way. Seymour in the Sodi cart. The Unifilter Penrite Oil, sponsored number 10, in second position, but plenty of pressure. Looks like it might be Sirigello right on his back bumper as they head through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. Kart number 16, it is Sirigello, and then it's the fastest qualifier on Friday, the 55 of Simon Kendrick, who runs back there in fourth position. Now, behind him is Philip Borg. He was the second fastest qualifier, but also had problems, particularly this morning when he had a high speed off going into the S's on lap one of heat number 3. And he is now trying to work his way back up through the field. So, a spin at the top of the circuit. Three carts involved in that incident. It's fortunately... not impacted on our front runners, but Phelan leading the way now under pressure from Seymour. So Luke Seymour just showing some great speed. It's Sydney versus Lithgow at the front of the field. Zach Phelan in the 49, your race leader from Luke Seymour in the 10. The Unifilters Penrite Oil Sodi cart from Lithgow. Sirigello, another of the Sydney runners, as the 24 limps past. That's Graham Stevens with a very bent rear axle. Phelan under pressure from Seymour with Sirigello back there in third in that 16 cart. And Kendrick there in the 55 looking for his opportunity. Gap back further to Borg. And then it's Presser, Bowen, Field and Blewett, the last of the carts still out there on the circuit. Now Phelan under pressure as coming off the top turn. Seymour makes the move and Seymour is your new race leader. The Sodi card hits the front for the first time in this final. Phelan works through the S's in the Tony speed as Kendrick in the other of the DKS race engines as Bowen is off the circuit. So the 32 from Canberra, unfortunately not going to play a part in this final, or any further part, I should say. So Seymour leading the way, skipping away from Phelan now, as up the inside. Sirigello, the runaway motorsports team, having another solid run here in the final, as Sirigello in the 16 is now your second place runner. Nose to tail. So Phelan and Kendrick, nose to tail as they head up the pit straight. Kendrick in the Esprit, the 49 and the 55, as off the circuit goes Borg. So 71 just coming off the top turns, gets into the dirt there, and that has affected part of his run down the hill that time. So Seymour had a half a second gap between himself and Sirigello. That gap is still extensively the same, although Sirigello now sets the fastest lap of the race, a 33.854. So the Runaway Motorsports number 16 doing well here as he sets himself up for a run at Seymour, who leads by just on half a second. The two DKS race engine carts, both from the North Shore Karting Club, or representing the North Shore Karting Club here, still in contention for a podium spot, is Phelan, with Kendrick just starting to the clutches of Philip Borg in the 71. And then another battle right at the back of the field between Jamie Field by Blewett now, as they head up the pit straight. Our leaders are heading through the S's, and it's still Luke Seymour out in front. He extended his gap on that last lap. What will it be now? It stays about 0.7 of a second. So Sirigello not making much of an inroad here on our leader in Luke Seymour, as they head down the service potential back straight and towards the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. It's still Seymour, Sirigello. Has Phelan found something now and he's starting to close in on Sirigello? Daniel Sirigello, last lap was a 33.8. Phelan's last lap was a 34.2. This time across the line, they're both doing 34. Sirigello a 34.08 and Phelan a 34.04. Kendrick, who was up in the back bumper of Phelan a few laps ago now, has dropped back further, and his last lap was half a second slower than that front group. So he is now definitely falling into the clutches of Philip Borg, who was 0.4 of a second faster than him on that last run through. We'll see how the gaps change. It's halved now, as Sirigello has closed in on Luke Seymour by 0.3 of a second on that last lap. Seymour running a 34.3, Sirigello a 33.9, and then it's Phelan on a 34.0. Kendrick still in fourth position with Borg behind him. Pross is all by himself back there in sixth place, with Blewett now pulling away from Field with the eight carts still out there on the circuit. So our race leader in Luke Seymour. As I mentioned before, the heat races had a multitude of results. Seymour was fourth in heat number three earlier today, with Sirigello taking a 2 second victory. In heat two, which was run, our fastest qualifier beat Seymour from Phelan. Sirigello was back in fifth place on that occasion. And then in the opening heat of the weekend, it was Phelan who managed to stay tough and take the victory after there was a lot of banging and crashing going on in that first heat. Seymour was second, with Sirigello back there in third. So Seymour continues to lead here in kart number 10. So for the Sodi kart, Unifilter Penrite Oils connection. uneventful for sure. Sirigello in the 16, he's trying to make it a bit more exciting, but the leaders all running in the 33.7s currently, although Kendrick has just put in the fastest lap of the race, a 33.661. So Kendrick in the 55 kart, running in fourth position, now starting to put a bit of a charge, looking to try and get himself onto a podium finish. They're pulling away from the 71 of Philip Borg as they head across the start-finish line with six laps remaining. So our leader is Luke Seymour. Sirigello, this lap has not been able to close the gap. It's 0.4 of a second now. Thielen and Kendrick both within 0.1 of a second of each other's lap times that last time. Blue light this next time by. The blue lights are on as the leader, Seymour, now has Sirigello within a kart length. So it's tightened up at the front. And also Kendrick now closing in on Phelan in that second and third positions. And Kendrick now looking to the inside of Phelan through the top turns. Phelan holds him off for the moment. Can the back marker prove to be a factor here in how this race concludes? The tag 125 restricted heavy final here in the Dunlop Kart Sports New South Wales Karting Championships as across the line, Seymour and Sirigello right on each other's back bumper as they work their way around the top of the circuit. Sirigello has got the advantage of being the second runner on the back marker, but the back marker does a good job, gets well out of the way now, and our front battle has not been interrupted by that. The battle for third, though, could be an interesting one as Phelan couldn't get in front of the back marker before the S's. So that means Kendrick is now right on his back bumper. So two distinct battles here as Field tries to get out of the way of that third place battle. So Seymour leading the way as they head around the top turns once again. But Sirigello in that blue driving suit with the dark coloured helmet, kart number 16 there. The Esprit kart is looking to try and do everything in his power to get past the Lithgow runner. As they come across the start-finish line, two laps remain. So Seymour, what can he do to defend his position? Last lap time, there was 0.1 of a second difference between Seymour and Sirigello. So Sirigello has got the momentum at the moment as Phelan and Kendrick continue their battle on for third. It looks like that one's died off for the moment. What can Sirigello do? Seymour through the S's, still maintaining that lead and has got it out to about 0.2 of a second now. In fact, it's 0.3 as they go past the start-finish line. So Seymour leading from Sirigello. Phelan's pulled away again from Kendrick as our leaders head back down the service Lop Kart Sports dip. They head toward and around the top of the circuit. Seymour will hold on. Sirigello takes the home in third with Kendrick. Field is one lap down in the five. Philip Borg round across standings, but Luke Seymour from Lithgow in the Unifield has taken the first championships in tag restricted heavy.
For a home loan health check, financing inquiries, debit inquiries, home loan purchases or investment purchases. If you are thinking of home improvements or renovations, it's free to have an appointment to look at your needs. Call Jennifer on 0414 243 726.
kN central fuel force, infrared remote control.
How does he do it?
24.5 kilowatt diesel motor.
He doesn't just know how to operate every piece of Kennard's high gear. Safety checks.
I don't know.
It's as if he can hypnotise each piece.
Give me two passes with sauce. Coffee white with one, bun with icing. No, pink icing.
Yep, no worries, Terry.
I think we should get a professional to fix it.
If I could just get it started.
Leave your car in the capable hands of the mechanics at Mechanical Care, specialising in logbook servicing, brakes, tyres, steering, suspension and ACT in New South Wales rego and gas renewals. Plus, you can get a lift back to your work or borrow a car or ute for the day or shop at Westfield while your car is serviced. For family-friendly services, call Mechanical Care Belconnen on 6251 4883.
What a drag. No, not you, mate. Ordinary fuel's clogging up your engine with filthy dirt. It's like lugging around one of these. New BP Ultimate eats up the dirt like 1,000 ravenous piranhas. It busts dirt in just 2 tanks. It's designed for a smoother drive and more kilometres per tank.
KA4 Junior Heavies. Zach Zambrogno is in the 43 and he'll start on the pole, the Riga Construction CRG. With Lachlan Maneef in the 28, that's the JV Motorsports kart with the Villa Truck Rental Fleet sponsorship. Darcy Inwood in the 25, the Esprit A1 Towing. Fardell from Coffs Harbour in the Mr. HDT race cars, number 11. Jordan Giannopoulos rounds out the top 5 with a 35 card. Then it's Caruso. Queens in the 12. Braden Taylor's in the 19. Sasha Stefanovic in the 67. Taylor Harness has had a wicked weekend. The Grenfell driver is hoping that she... final. She starts from position number 10. Angus McLean's in the 10 kart, starting from 11. Elias Taparis in the 18. And Benito Montalbano in the 69. I'm just looking. I can't see him out there, so he's not going to take part in this final. So Zach Zamprogno in the 43 to lead them to the start line. No start this time, though. Maneef in the 28. Darcy Inwood in the 25. All showing good speed this weekend. Now, give you an idea of how the heats have panned out throughout the racing so far. Maneef won Heat 1 on Saturday. Then it was Zamprogno who won Heat 2. Heat 3 this morning was Zach Zamprogno eventually getting the win, although Benito Montalbano went across the line first. So we get set. Zamprogno and Maneef. They've shown good even speed throughout the weekend. This final, 20 laps the distance, will be interesting to see how it all pans out. So KA4 Junior Heavies. They are racing. Zamprogno gets the jump off the start. Maneef and Fardell work their way single file through into the first turns. As they head up the pit straight now, they work their way around the top turns, and it looks like Zamprogno has pulled out an unlikely jump off the start. As we go through the dip and up over the rise, Zamprogno from Maneef. The 13 kart of Caruso. Now two karts involved in an incident here as they have been caught going into the S's. Taylor Harness in the 48. Her weekend continues to be a disaster. And the 35 of the Jordan Giannopoulos also involved in that incident. So at the front of the field, Zamprogno leads by half a second over Lachlan Maneef. Caruso in the 13. Then it's Fardell in the 11. As they go back the top four, and they work through the S's. Then you go back to McQueen, Taylor and Stefanovic, who are quite close together. And right behind them also Taparis and McLean. Inwood in the 25 has dropped right down to the back of the field, so he's got some work to do now, with Giannopoulos Harness both no longer part of this event. So it's the Riga Constructions, number 43 from Sydney, setting the fastest lap of the race, last time by in the 34.408. Caruso now working his way around the bottom of the circuit in third position, right on the back of Manif. And then it's Fardell in the 11, who is working his way up in fourth place. So Manif and Caruso is the battle for second to watch. As Fardell in the 11, then it's McQueen, Taylor, Stefanovic, McLean, Taparis and Inwood rounds out. So our leader, Zamprogno, 1.5 second advantage at the front of the field. He's got Lachlan Manif, almost 0.6 of a second slower, or 0.5 of a second actually slower than his last lap. Nicholas Caruso in the 13, trying to put the pressure on, but that gap's just opening up as they head through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip, up over the rise and towards the S's once again. Fardell working hard, trying to get himself through the S's. Then it's McQueen, Riley McQueen in fifth place, with the pressure on from the 67 now. The 67 of Sasha Stefanovic in the Arrow. That's the Devesi Constructions Group kart. It's the camera kart too for this final. Sasha Stefanovic. Zach Zimprogno leading the way from Lachlan Manif, who's still not being challenged by Caruso at the moment. So the 11 of Fardell sitting in fourth place and now coming under some pressure from the 12 of Riley McQueen. So the PCR of Riley McQueen is starting to really battle it out here. Fardell from Coffs, Riley McQueen from Wollongong, as Caruso is also closing in again on the second place runner of Lachlan Manif. So the Birrell Kart, the Tiger Trays UKS number 13 of Nicholas Caruso, heads up the start finish straight and is as the Stefanovic Kart. We see the on-car pitches now, the pit straight, and Stefanovic is in the seventh position as the leaders work their way down the pit straight. As in the inside of Manif is Caruso, and Caruso will take second position. So Caruso in second, Manif in third. A good couple of laps there, just building up to that pass from Caruso, and eventually makes the move up the inside. Manif in third, McQueen in fourth, as the leaders work their round. Now I think Stefanovic is trying to make a move on Fardell, who's fallen back through the field. No, it was actually the McQueen, or no, it was the Brandon Taylor kart perhaps, that's now made that move. So Caruso consolidating second, third is McQueen, Inwood has worked his way back forward, then it's Fardell, Taylor, McLean, Taparis, Stefanovic back there at the rear of the field now. So Zamprogno well out in front, four, almost 5 seconds that advantage. Caruso has got Manif right on his back bumper again. And now we could have a battle for fourth in the next lap or so, as Darcy Inwood has worked his way from the back of the field up into this fifth position. Now I saw the black and white diagonals going out to kart 13. That's the Nicholas Caruso kart. So he'll have a visit to the stewards at the end of this race. Caruso in the second position. Manif up the inside, and Manif that time had been working on that move for a couple of laps as well. So both these drivers so evenly matched, they don't just come out and make a move like that. They have to work on it steadily over the course of the race. And now Manif in the JV Motorsports, number 28, is back up into second position. So our race leader is still Zakson Brogno in the Riga Construction CRG from Eastern Creek, the North Shore Karting Club, leading the way here from the two Lithgow drivers. One, of course, based out of both Lithgow drivers, Manif and Caruso, so they'll be familiar with each other, familiar with what they normally do when they're in a hard battle. Fardell from Griffith just getting passed now by Angus McLean from Newcastle. So McLean's grabbed another spot there as Fardell's final has gone the wrong way for the Coffs Harbour driver. Our leader with seven laps to go, Zak Brogno from Manif and then back to Caruso. Darcy and Wood now is 3.3 seconds off the battle for second. So can Darcy Inwood, in the time remaining, be able to make some ground? Zimprogno well under control here. His gap over 7 seconds. Now I've just heard that Blake Fardell has pulled his card off the circuit. So a disappointing finish for the youngster in kart 11, but I'm sure he'll be back in the next round as the New South Wales Kart Championships heads to Newcastle next. The 43 of Zamprogno, Manif with 15 laps now concluded, this time by the start finish line. Lap 15 is completed now. The leader around the top of the circuit. Now this battle for second seems to have hotted up again. Darcy Inwoods must have made a mistake out there on the circuit because he was closing in on that battle. But Riley McQueen in the 12 has now taken him back. So as the second place battle of Manif and Caruso head through the S's once again. I think Inwood is back ahead of McQueen. So Inwood and McQueen just settling their battle for fourth and fifth position. As the leader works around the top of the circuit, it's Zamprogno leading by over 8.6. Just skipping away from Caruso. Caruso now about a kart length behind. He closes up through the S's though. He had a big run through the S's that time. He was three kart lengths back going into the S's and now is within a kart length. So has Caruso just saved his tyres a little bit, let them cool down slightly, and decided he's going to make a run here with less than three laps to go? They head up around the top of the circuit once again, and Manif is under pressure from the 13 kart of Nicholas Caruso. The Tiger Trays, UKS Birrell, is sitting back there in third. Yes, the JV Motorsports, Villa Truck Florent Fleet number 28 is holding the 13 back at the moment. They head through the pit turn once again. 1.5 laps remain for this battle for second. Now Caruso goes to the outside as Manif protects the inside towards the dip. He just keeps his kart off that favourable line by about 0.5 kart length to make Caruso think about what he has to do and make sure he can do it cleanly. Caruso, though, down through the bottom section of track, is extremely quick. So Zamprogno under the white flag. He is well out in front. He's extended his lead now to 10 seconds. It's a huge performance here from Zamprogno now. Caruso tried to make his move coming off the top turn. It didn't quite pay off, but has Manif got enough room? Zamprogno takes the victory as the battle for second heads through the S's. It's going to be Manif holding on, but Caruso goes to the inside. Manif and Caruso side by side as they come off the top turn. Caruso will go across the line in second. Third place is Manif. Inwood comes home in fourth. McQueen in the PCR is fifth. Then it's back to Taylor, a quiet run for Braden Taylor in the last part of that race. Then it follows back to Taparis, Stefanovic, McLean, rounding out the runners in KA for Junior Heavy. Zach Zamprogno dominated over 11.8 seconds, his victory margin here in the final.
The July, it's over to Grenfell for the Bob Hine Memorial and Festival of the Kids, round 7 of the Canberra Kart Racing Club Championship. The midwinter sprint is on the 31st of July. Check the Canberra Kart Racing Club website for the 27th and 28th of August, when the Taz O'Hara meeting is to be confirmed. On the 18th of September, the 10th round of the championship will roar into action. On the 16th of October will be round 11, with round 12 culminating in the Service Potential Canberra Cup on the 19th and 20th of November. We hope you can join us back here at Circuit Mark Webber throughout season 2016.
BP Queanbeyan is a proud sponsor of the Canberra Kart Racing Club. They provide control fuel for all the club's major events and offer petrol, diesel and gas for your road car as well. With a Wild Bean Cafe, LPG bottled gas, car wash and more, BP Queanbeyan is your one-stop shop. BP Queanbeyan on Yass Road, it's just on the right as you go under the bridge on your way into town. Proud sponsors of the Canberra Kart Racing Club.
The Canberra Kart Racing Club would like to thank Cooper's Photography for joining us once again here at the Circuit Mark Webber. If you're interested in getting photos from the weekend, they have the $50 CD deal. It includes action shots, personal shots, group start and finish photos. These quality images can be viewed at any time over the weekend on the large screen at the Cooper's Photography display. Now you can purchase the images and you can collect them after your final race, or for an additional $5 they can be sent directly to you. Go and see Nikki down there at Cooper's Photography for more details.
Angelo and his team.
So it's the tag 125 heavies heading out onto the circuit. Benjamin Ritchie, Jason Varley, it'll be an interesting battle here. Ritchie in the 60, Varley in the 10. Second row is the 71 of Michael Osman, Josh Pontaleone. Then it's Brett Robinson in the 75. Mitchell Wall is in the 5. Tony Brigoni in the 31. Michael Dorman in the 7, Robert Hogan in the 25, Kyle Jackson is in the 27, Matthew Endres in the 74, Owen Guthrie in the 83, Zach Van Leeuwstren in the 4, Dominic Marciano in the 15, Liam Clark in the 59, Chris Cheatham in the 95, James Ordish in the 17, Greg Moores in the 67, six of Michael Hogan rounds out the field. 19 runners to greet the starter here in the tag 125 heavy final. No start that time by, so Ritchie, who starts on the pole, was in fact the fastest qualifier. Tony Brigoni was second fastest with Jason Varley. In heat one, which was the only heat they ran yesterday, it was Ritchie from Robinson and Dorman. Then in the two heats today, it was Varley ahead of Ritchie in heat two in the treacherous conditions this morning. And then it was Ritchie over Osmond and Wall with Varley in fourth in heat three. So Ritchie's got the form, but can he translate it with the multiple Australian champion and former New South Wales champion on his outside? It'll be an interesting race to say the least, and they're formed up now. They're racing, and Ritchie gets the start. Going with him, there's a bunch of bash and crash as they head into turn number one, but it's Osmond who got through into second. Varley fought back, and I think Varley might have grabbed that second place back as they head around the top of the circuit. He has indeed. So Osmond in the 71 runs in third as they head down into the Dunlop Kart Sports Tip. For the first time, the 77 of Robinson works his way through the S's in fourth position, whilst the 28 of Pontello is back there in fifth position. A wheel slipped out onto the dirt now on Dorman's cart, with Jackson, Bragoni, Hogan and Wall rounding out the top 10. As the leaders work their way around the top of the circuit, it is Benjamin Ritchie in the 60 who works their way through the dip and up over the rise. Varley is right behind him by a cart length. They head through the S's, and the 71 is in third place still with Robinson behind him. So Robert Hogan in the 25 is off the circuit down. He had a spin going into the S's. And so that's the first of our DNFs for this tag 125 heavy final. Around the top of the circuit, Ritchie and Varley, not much between them. Osmond doing well here. He's pulled away from the 77 of Robinson. Then it's Pontello who's got that 28 cart with a bit of a gap back to Kyle Jackson now. Jackson from Wollongong in the East Strategies cart, up into sixth position. Dorman in the 7, that's the JC, the James Courtney cart, Shazzy, in seventh place. Bragoni, the Platinum Karting World Tony Kart, is running in eighth place. But our leader is Benjamin Ritchie. The Lithgow driver has won many a track and race in his day, and he is doing it comfortably in the Intrepid at the front of the field. Varley had the fastest lap of the race, but now Ritchie has taken it from him with a 32.726. So Benjamin Ritchie, fastest kart on the circuit currently, and is just kicking away slightly from Jason Varley. Varley under brakes, closes that gap up. He's skipping away from Osmond, who's got Robinson closing in on him. As Robinson in the 77 continues to hold fourth place. Pontello, Jackson. Now Bragoni has got past Dorman. So Bragoni in the 31. Dorman in the 7 have swapped positions on that lap. So it's the Intrepid of Ritchie who leads the way from the DR Racing cut of James Varley. Osmond in third place, not being challenged as yet by Brett Robinson. Pontello still in fifth place. Now Varley is pushing hard. He's closed up that gap as Ritchie and Varley nose to tail around the top of the circuit, but Ritchie still looks like he's got things under control. Third place, Osmond, with some breathing room behind him is Robinson. So a top four carts, all in a good position at the moment, as the weather here at the circuit, Mark Webber, has continued to improve throughout the day, although a howling breeze across the track has made tricky conditions for all out there on the circuit. Ritchie, fastest lap of the race, that 32.609. And his last lap was 0.1 seconds faster than Varley. Osmond now being caught by Robinson, as it looks like Jackson has been able, no, has been passed, in fact, by the 31 of Bragoni. So Tony Bragoni was the second fastest qualifier in the session on Friday, and now he is starting to make a move up around the top of the circuit. The 60 of Richie leads from Varley. Osmond still holding off Robinson, but look for the 31 of Bragoni, who's closing in now. Tony Bragoni in the 31. The Platinum and Karting World Tony Kart has really put in a solid drive here up through the field and is now putting the pressure on the 28 of Pontello. Going into the dip, Pontello still holding that fifth position ahead of Bragoni. Further back, a couple of good battles. The 15 of Marciano, Van Luestren and Clark have all been mixing it up throughout this race. Our race leader, though, is still Richie, who's pulling away from Varley. Now, Pontello holding off Tony Bragoni's charge forward, as Bragoni was trying to make a move at the top of the circuit. Back there in the 27, Kyle Jackson. He's also in a position to challenge as well, as they work around the final turn with 9 laps remaining. Richie continues to lead from Varley. Varley in second position. He has put in a solid drive in the tricky conditions this morning. It was a very, very exciting race. Now, the wind at the circuit seems to have turned around slightly and is going more along the straights now than across the track. And so that is certainly going to change the way that the drivers will be able to attack, because in some instances, like coming down the hill here, they're going to have a much higher headwind heading up the back straight. They're going to have that tailwind supporting them. So as Varley in the 10 continues to push on, Robinson now has caught Osmond and is really putting the pressure on there. So a battle for third looks like it is well underway. The race leader, still Richie, by just 0.07 of a second. Now, a mistake by Osmond as he came off the top turns. Will that open the door for Robinson? No, it doesn't look like it will. Robinson not close enough to take advantage of that slight mistake. Another of the Lisco runners, but this one in a Tony K. Brett Robinson from Orange in the CRG Australia sponsored entry works his way around the top of the circuit. Brett Robinson in the 77, of course, is a state champion, as Varley makes the move now going into the S's, as Robinson tried to do exactly the same thing. Robinson into the back of Osmond as Varley is your leader. So Varley in the 10 card, can he pull away from Richie as they made the move going down into the S's that time? Our race leader, Jason Varley, he won his first New South Wales State Championship 2 years ago now at Lithgow. Richie comes back at him, a bit of a touch mid-corner as they go through the S's now. Robinson has made the pass for third on Osmond as well. So Varley and Richie. Robinson up to third. So the orange driver in the CRG Australia sponsored entry, still with Osmond in the Tony Kart right behind him. Robinson wide, coming off the top turns that time. So what can Osmond do to get the spot back? Robinson just going into the S's, a fair bit slower than what Osmond expected. There was a bit of nose-tail contact there, but as they come across the start finish line, here goes Osmond. He goes into the pit turn, but Robinson still holds him up. All right, Robinson working his way up into third position. He's trying his best to continue on as a lead change at the front of the field. Richie goes back ahead of Varley. So Varley back to second. Robinson in the CRG Australia Galaxy. Oh, Galaxy powered kart, I should say. Works his way up into third and holds that spot now. Osman hasn't been able to get back past. Richie, who looked like he had got passed by Varley and Varley was going to drive away, is now in a position to hold off Varley again. We'll watch the battle at the front of the field. The white flag is out. And it's Benjamin Ritchie in the Intrepid at the front of the field from Jason Varley. Ahead of the battle for third is Robinson and also Michael Osman. So as they head around the top of the circuit, your race leader continues to be Benjamin Ritchie. Varley looks too far back to challenge now as the 60 of Ritchie, the Intrepid, heads down into the final S's for the final time. Through the final turns, Varley's closed up on him again. But Benjamin Ritchie takes the first round of the New South Wales Kart Championships for Tag Heavy. Second place, Jason Varley. Brett Robinson in the CRG Galaxy-powered kart runs in third. Osmond in the 71 comes home in fourth. Then it's Tony Bragoni, who drove up through the field but just couldn't get better than fifth. Kyle Jackson in sixth. Josh Pontello, he dropped back late in the race but had a good run throughout. Marciano in the 15 is eighth. Ninth is Dorman. Then it's Wall in the 10. Van Luestren's 11th, Clark is 12th, Guthrie, Cheatham and Ordish round out the top 15 with Moores and Hogan rounding out the finishes here in the tag. 125 heavy at Circuit Mark Webber, the home of the Canberra Kart Racing Club. This is the Dunlop Kart Sports New South Wales Karting Championships. Cadet Nines, Costa Tabara starts on the pole in the 43. That's the Greengrocers Cycling Cosmic Kart. Leon Cordato in the 65 starts out of position number 2. Sebastian Ruiz in the 28 out of 3. The 15 is Darcy Boulding. The 67 is Jet Cotter. Mako Hazard is in the 37. James Freeborn in the 5. Ryan Holborough in the 7. Marshall Crofts in the 34. The 2 is Reg Barry. And Brody Mortlock's in the 33. Some good driving in the Cadet Nines throughout the weekend. We hope it continues here in what is a long race, a 20-lap final. As they're formed up now, about right for a start. Taparis and Cordato racing, and it's Taparis who gets the jump. Ruiz goes with them. Cordato gets caught, one out, one back, and I think Boulding has got checked up because of that, and Jet Cotter has got through into third position. We watch them as they head around the top of the circuit and it is still the Costa Taparis 43 holding off the 28 of Ruiz. Back there, Ruiz up the inside on Taparis, and Ruiz will take the lead. Cordato is your running in third position for the moment. Fourth position, in fact, because the 67 card Object Cotter did manage to make that good start and up into third place. So Ruiz in the Ruiz Construction, Tony Kart leads Costa Taparis in the Cosmic. Of course, Costa Taparis, the Greengrocer Cycling entry based out of Goulburn. Then it's Jet Cotter in the Lithgows, Synergy Motorsport, Gary's Motorsports Esprit running in, well, fourth place now, is a fifth place, in fact, as Cotter has been passed by both Cordato and also Darcy Balding. So Darcy Balding in the 15, another of the Lithgow drivers around the top of the circuit. Our leaders, Sebastian Ruiz. Fastest lap of the race, a 37.403, and you'd expect those times to continue to drop throughout this final. As Costa Taparis closes in on the back of the 28 cart, Cordato now has also got some clean track ahead to try and close the gap with Balding and Cotter. Freeburn, Hazard, Crofts, Holborough, Barry and Mortlock round out the running order. So Ruiz in the Ruiz Construction, Tony Kart leading the way, Kart 28, after an up and down round of heats for Sebastian Ruiz. A DNF in heat number one after just five laps, where Cordato, Balding and Cotter took the front spots. In heat two, Cordato and Ruiz battled it out with Taparis right to the end. And then in heat three, it was Ruiz taking the victory from Balding and Taparis. That time it was Cordato that had dramas in his Monaco kart. But Ruiz leading the way from Taparis, the Kart School Monaco, number 65 of Cordato, consolidating that third place and, in fact, trying to push on to get onto the back of Taparis. Then the gap back to Darcy Balding, a further gap back to Jet Cotter with Freeburn, and then Hazard, Crofts, Holbrow, Barry and Mortlock making up the runners. Sebastian Ruiz. The gap, 0.2 of a second last time, 0.17 of a second this time. So Ruiz just getting through that pit turn, opening up a bit of a gap on Costa Taparis. But Cordato is looking like that Leon Cordato is going to make a challenge for second place. He runs very wide coming out of the top turns. And that's opened the door for Darcy Balding to make a move around the outside, going down the service potential back straight. And Darcy Balding is now up into third position. So Balding, the Grenfell driver in the Country Charms, Yas Arrow, kart number 15, up into third. Cordato in the Monaco kart, running in fourth and looking desperately to try and get himself back on the podium. Sebastian Ruiz in the 28, Costa Taparis in the 43, working their way around Darcy Balding and Cordato side by side again, and Cordato will take third place back as they come off the top turns. So Ruiz now out in front, probably his biggest gap for a while as he heads through the final turns and onto the start-finish straight. It's Sebastian Ruiz in the Ruiz Construction Tony Kart leading the way from Costa Taparis. Taparis, though, able to close down that gap as they came across the start-finish line. So Ruiz now we'll have a new challenger for second. Taparis has had Cordato go up the inside off the top turns, and Cordato is now up into second position. So Taparis back to third, and Balding still running in fourth. The top four have pulled away quite markedly from Jet Cotter in the 67. Cotter from Lithgow in the Synergy, Gary's Motorsports, number 67. Then it's back to Freeburn, Hazard, Holborough, rounding out the top eight carts. Further then back to Barry and Crofts, with Brody Mortlock, I think, off the circuit somewhere. as Ruiz now has got the hard charging Sydney driver from the kart school's entry. Monaco kart up against the Tony kart here, and we still have 11 laps to run, so a long way to go as they work their way through the pit turn. Another battle on the circuit. Back towards the back is between Barry and Crofts, the 2 and the 34. Yeah, the 2 and the 34 is just sorting themselves out now, but have been nose to tail. And oh, change for the lead at the top of the circuit. Leon Cordato has made the move. Ruiz straight back up the inside, going into the S's though. And Cordato and Ruiz mixing it up again. They've had some tough races so far throughout this weekend. And Ruiz, well, in the 28 kart, Ruiz construction entry, he needs to just make sure he measures how he's running at the front of the field, because Cordato there was able to make a very, very solid pass around the top of the track. As the leader heads into the S's, Cordato thought about a move. Darcy Boulding just got into the back there of Taparis slightly, as Taparis runs in third place. Boulding in the 15 kart runs in fourth. Here's come Cordato again up into the pit turn. They're side by side, working their way through. I think Ruiz has managed to hang on to it once again up the back straight. It's Ruiz from Cordato. Side by side, Cordato now makes the move coming off the top turns, and Cordato is your new race leader. Cordato in the 65, Ruiz in the 28, works their way up over the rise. Ruiz straight back up the inside, going into the S's, and that has given Taparis now the opportunity to close that gap up. Darcy Boulding has just set the fastest lap of the race. The 15 kart from Grenfell, a 36.682. Darcy Boulding's time. He's running fourth on the racetrack as they work their way around the top of the circuit once again. This time Ruiz is able to cover off any move by Cordato, as Boulding was looking to try and range up on the outside of the Taparis kart. So Taparis under plenty of pressure from the hard charging number 15 of Darcy Boulding. Through the final turn, and Ruiz has opened up his gap once again. At the line, it was 0.3 of a second. They head up to the top of the circuit now. Darcy Boulding has dropped back along that pit straight, and so he's losing touch with the top three as they head around the top of the circuit. I hope nothing's wrong for Darcy Boulding, who has the race so far. He did that on lap 10. As Ruiz now again finds Cordato closing in on him. They have still six laps left to run, so a long way to go in this race. Ruiz, Cordato, and then back to Taparis. Boulding is falling away. There's another good battle with Jet Cotter. Hazard getting past Freeburn as well. That is a battle for 5th, 6th and 7th coming off the top turns now. So Ruiz continues to lead through the S's, and Cordato gets a great run onto the main straight once again. So Ruiz is losing a bit of time in the middle of the S's. He's on the left-hand turn. That's where he is just bogging it down slightly, and it's costing him a fair bit of track position, which was hard fought to get in the first place. They are nose to tail, first and second now, as they head through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip once again. It's Ruiz from Cordato. Taparis is still in with a chance here as Costa Taparis closes in. Boulding still sitting back about a second off the main bunch. Then it's back to this other good battle, Cotter, Hazard and Freeburn. They've been mixing it up over the last few laps, and at the moment they've settled it down as our leaders head off the top turn and back down the service potential back straight. Cordato looking to the inside that time, but not close enough really to challenge. So Cordato in that 65. Monaco Kart School sponsored kart out of Sydney. The North Shore Karting Club represented there by Leon Cordato. It's Canberra's Sebastian Ruiz leading from Leon Cordato. Then it's back to Costa Taparis in third, who's just losing ground on that main budge. Cordato makes the move up the inside through the top turns. And Cordato is your new race leader. Now we're coming up on the back marker of, is that Brody Mortlock? Front. Ruiz goes back to the front as the blue lights are flashing for the 33 of Brody Mortlock. Ruiz, Cordato, and now Taparis. All three carts nose to tail as they work their way around the pit turn and up the pit straight once again. Around the top of the circuit, Ruiz gets through cleanly, as does Cordato. So they're all through. The battle at the front, though, is continuing on. I think Cordato going side by side on Ruiz, and Cordato makes the move, going into the Dunlop dip. But as Ruiz back through the inside into the S's once again, Cordato just holding the lead fractionally then as they battle under the white flag now. Sebastian Ruiz leading the way from Leon Cordato. They work their way up the pit straight. Cordato is strong around the top turns as they work that way now. Cordato just loses a bit of ground on Ruiz that time. And Taparis is still there looking to try and make a run. Cordato, though, pushing hard down through the dip. And Ruiz, Cordato, Ruiz up the inside. Cordato and Ruiz side by side through the S's. Taparis is going to come back at him as well. Taparis around the outside of Cordato for second as the race winner is Sebastian Ruiz. Ruiz takes the victory. Costa Taparis home in a thrilling second place. Leon Cordato in the 65. Darcy Boulding in the 15. Fifth place is Jet Cotter. Macca Hazard in the 37. James Freeborn in the 5. The 77 is Ryan Holborough. Then it's Reg Barry in the 2. Marshall Crofts in the 34. And Brody Mortlock in the 11. Thrilling race. Ruiz getting the win at the end of the Cadet Nines final here in the Dunlop Kart Sports New South Wales Karting Championships. Rodney Phillips in the 45 is the pole sitter here for the tag 125 restricted lights final. Lachlan O'Hara in the 24 will start out of position number 2. Dylan Nielsen in the 95, Royce Gay in the 78, Jordan Phillips in the 46, Cameron Kendall in the 35, Matthew Kenneth in the 8, Robert Broughton in the 16, Adam Martin in the 34, Nathan Stevens in the 98, the 58 is Nicholas Pagen, and then the 91 is Josh Bean. So Phillips, starting on the pole, has had a solid weekend. He finished ahead of Matthew Kenneth in heat number 1 and Royce Gay. Then in heat 2 this morning, it was Phillips, Kenneth, Gay again with O'Hara in fourth. Heat 3 was Phillips, Kenneth, O'Hara with Nielsen and Jordan Phillips that time. Gay a non-finisher. So that's why the 78 is starting out of position 4. Rodney Phillips and Lachlan O'Hara. Oh, good start from the inside line. The 24 getting left in the wake that time as they work their way up through the pit straight for the first time. So Phillips getting a good hole shot off the start. In second place at the top of the circuit is the 95 cart of Dylan Nielsen. Royce Gay trying to make a move. He's been a good starter so far, but unfortunately on this occasion he's not in the second position as he has been on all his previous races. So Phillips leading the way from Nielsen. Kenneth in the 8 cart has had a great start. O'Hara, Phillips, Gay, Kendall, Borden, Stevens, Pagen, Martin and Bean is the running order. So as the leader heads through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip, the 95 of Nielsen. Nielsen holding back the onslaught of Kenneth from Sydney in the Long Reef Landscapes Tony Kart. And then Lachlan O'Hara in the OTK kart from Newcastle. So as they work around, it's Kenneth making a move on the inside of Nielsen. He completes the car pass coming off the top turns. And Kenneth now works his way up into second position. O'Hara trying to go up the inside of Nielsen into the S's. And O'Hara has had a spin. So O'Hara drops to the back of the circuit as our leader, Rodney Phillips, Kenneth Nielsen, then it's Phillips, Kendall, Broughton, Gay, Stevens, Pagen, Martin, O'Hara and Bean is now the new running order. So our race leader, Rodney Phillips, consistent throughout this weekend's racing. Matt Kenneth, fortunately, has had an up and down weekend. Nielsen now coming good at the right time of the weekend in this final, running third with Jordan Phillips, who's been steadily building up throughout the races also across the 2 days of racing. Cameron Kendall rounds out the five. And all top five carts have broken away now from the rest of the pack. So Bowen, Gay, Stevens and Pagen in a good battle here for 6th, 7th. As our leader works their way across the start-finish line, completing a quarter of the race that time by. So the Tag 125 restricted lights final, and the 91 of Josh Bean now in trouble. And I think Bean has decided that's enough. The Dubbo driver in the Energy Kart with a Double City Welding Works sponsorship has pulled off the circuit. So Rodney Phillips holding Kenneth at about a 0.7 gap, but Kenneth is the fastest kart on the circuit as he heads up around the top of the track once again. Rodney Phillips is the leader. Phillips then back to Kenneth. Through the dip, it's still Jordan Phillips holding off Kendall and getting Cameron Kendall, who's got Robert Broughton, who's also got Dylan Nielsen, now starting to fade back through the pack. So 0.4 of a second between your leader in Rodney Phillips and Matt Kenneth. So Kenneth is closing and has set the fastest lap of the race on that last lap, 33.055 was Matthew Kenneth's last lap time, and he's closed that gap further on this lap. So Rodney Phillips will need to respond now. Jordan Phillips in second position, the second of the Steve's Autobahn carts. Jordan Phillips running the Arrow and Rodney Phillips running the Sodi carts. First and third on the circuit. Kenneth is the man splitting him in the 8 cart. That's the Tony cart that heads into the S's now. And then Nielsen and Kendall having a good battle as Gay Gordon in the 16 cart. So the 35 makes the pass on Nielsen. So Cameron Kendall now from Sydney in the Sodi cart gets past Newcastle's Dylan Nielsen in the Ricardo cart. So as Rodney Phillips continues to respond to Kenneth's charges, Rodney Gay with a big spin. He has gone around and managed to gather things back up. Gay has done a and then gathered things back up, but he's fallen towards the back of the circuit. So another kart heading off the circuit is... I can't quite make out who that was, but I think it might have been Cameron Kendall involved. So our leaders come across the start-finish line. Rodney Phillips in the 45, leading the way from Matthew Kenseth. Then we go back to Jordan Phillips. Now, Cameron Kendall and Nielsen are still out on the circuit there, so it's O'Hara the next car through. So Robert Broughton, Nathan Stevens, and perhaps Adam Martin were all involved in that incident. And in fact, Stevens and Martin are still going around, so Broughton is the 16 cart that pulled itself off of the circuit. Our leaders working their way across the start-finish line now with 8 laps left to run. It's Phillips, Kenneth, and Phillips, the running order. Rodney Phillips with the fastest lap of the race, a 33.030. Matthew Kenneth in the 8 cart. The long reef of landscapes. Tony Kart just unable to close that gap. Jordan Phillips sits back there in third place, and the pressure is being applied to him by Cameron Kendall in the 35. So Cameron Kendall trying to get himself back onto the podium. And as they go around the top turn, Kendall's going to make the move. So Kendall, a good move there. Been closing in on Jordan Phillips over the last few laps. Jordan Phillips is coming back at him, but Phillips has to yield as they go through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. And Cameron Kendall is sitting there in third place now. Our leader is still Rodney Phillips in the Sodi cart. Then it's Kenneth. Cameron Kendall in the Intrepid works up to third. Phillips back to fourth. Then it's Nielsen, O'Hara, Pageant, Gay, Stevens and Martin rounding out the runners. So Kenneth has been not being closer to Rodney Phillips than any other time during 0.4. And so with 5 laps or under 5 laps left to run, Rodney Phillips and Matthew Kenneth could start dicing for position here, and they've got the added problem of 2 back markers, Nathan Stevens and Martin, who could be caught before the end of this race. So they come through the S's, and now there's nothing between Phillips and Kenneth. Half a cart length at the most as they head up with 4 laps left to run. So Matthew Kenneth, who's had a tough weekend, excluded from one race, and then has been up and down with results in the other two heats. He works his way, or I shouldn't say excluded, he had a penalty applied. And he goes to the outside of Phillips now. A little bit of contact there as they go into the S's. As they come off the final turn, that gives Phillips a little bit of breathing room with less than three laps to run. Kendall has made his third position fairly solid now ahead of Jordan Phillips. Nielsen and O'Hara not in a position to battle, but there is another battle going on between Padgett and Royce Gay further back in the field. Our leaders continue nose to tail through the S's for the third last time. They'll have two laps to run this time by. So Rodney Phillips leading the way as he heads up to the top of the circuit. Phillips, Kenneth, and then it's a big gap back to Kendall. Our battle is for the lead. Phillips and Kenneth. Phillips too far back, you'd think, to challenge into the S's this time as they work their way around the final turn. White flag is out. Kenneth back behind Phillips by 0.3 of a second. So Phillips would be hoping that that's a big enough buffer to be able to challenge or to stop the challenge for this position. But Phillips, Kenneth, first and second. Kenneth too far now to try and make a lunge. He heads into the S's behind Phillips. Phillips looks like he made a mistake going into the left-hander there. And Phillips, he'll come off the final turn. He holds on to win. And Phillips takes the victory. Kenneth home in second. Kendall in third. Fourth place going to Jordan Phillips. Then it's Dylan Neeson. Lachlan O'Hara will come home next with Gay ahead of Padgett. Stevens and Martin still sorting out their battle as they come through the final turns. And Stevens holding on in the 98 ahead of Martin. In from Lithgow takes the 125 restricted lights.
Don't forget to check out all the live timing available on Race Monitor. You can download the Race Monitor app or for your Windows, Android and Apple phones, as well as for your PC, your iPad and tablet. You can see all the timing and scoring live from the New South Wales Karting Championships this weekend in Canberra. Check out the App Store.
Ruwers Constructions. Whether it's a knockdown rebuild or a first home, there's a satisfied client at the end of every project. It's the Ruwers Guarantee. RuwersConstructions.com.au.
At Service Potential, we specialise in collaborating with companies to identify and achieve IT efficiencies to create a strategic business asset. By transforming an organisation's IT governance, IT service management and IT service operations, we support organisations to move away from reactive and unreliable IT functions. Call them on 0435 599 568 or email matt@servicepotential.com.au. Service Potential, major sponsor for the Canberra Cup 2016. What's communication?
The tag 125 restricted lights final has been completed, so we head now to the KA3 junior final. Oscar Priest is the fastest qualifier and pole sitter for the final. Zach Hurd in the 88. I'll tell you what, that was a very fast opening lap. Zach Hurd is in the 88. Now Jackson Suslin Harlow in the 75 has been very consistent. Zach Lobko won the first heat race today, which was the second heat race of the class. Thomas Sargent in the 47 runs in fifth, starts from fifth position. Travis Wharton, the 82 cart, Certainly an experienced campaigner. Watch for him to come out of position number six. Jaden Pope in the 24. Then it's Lewis Hodgson in the 30. Taylor Hazard in the 70. Zaxon Progno in the 43. Blake Fardle in the 11. Daniel Austin in the 29. Matthew Hill in the 76. Taylor Harness in the 48. Jeremy Hodgson. Theodore Lavas. And then it's Burton Hill, Stocks, O'Brien and Horsley. We're racing and a good start from Oscar Priest out in front of the field from a big spin off the end of the pit turn. And one card in the kitty litter is the 30, Lewis Hodgson. So Hodgson will take no further part in this final. Priest leads the way from the 75 of Suslin Harlow. Suslin Harlow followed then by Hurd, as Hurd runs in third. Oh, Suslin Harlow wheels well as he came up the start, finished straight that time. And that you'd think would cost him a bit of a track position, but in fact he's been able to hold on to second position for the moment. Back there in fourth place is Thomas Sargent in the 47. Then it's back to the Tony Kart, number three of Zach Lobko, who gets up the inside of Sargent and will make the pass. So Sargent in the 47, shuffled back to fifth position now with the 82 of Wharton, Pope, Hazard, Fardle and Zemprogno rounding out the top 10. Austin, Hill, Harness and Madison Hill make up the top 15. Rounding out the fields, Lavanis, Burton, Stocks, Horsley and O'Brien. So as the leader heads back up the start finish straight, it's Oscar Priest from Newcastle Spree who leads the way. Jackson Suslin Harlow having a solid run from Sydney in the Arbor Biz Lush model, number 75. Hearn in the top cart, the Next Gen Racing, number 88, also doing well. They've got a gap between themselves and Lobko as Wharton has got past Sargent. In fact, Sargent's been freight trained on that lap and he has fallen well back down the field. So Taylor Hazard doing well. Jaden Pope, Blake Fardle, Zemprogno now at Sargent in 10th position. As at the front of the field, Priest still maintaining that cart length advantage as he comes off the service potential back straight. As they work their way through the final turn again, Suslin Harlow again into the dirt. So now Hearn is definitely going to have a challenge. They head around the top of the circuit and Suslin Harlow still somehow manages to stay ahead of Hearn, who had all the momentum running up the hill that time. So Suslin Harlow working his way through the S's once again, and he is closed up onto the back of Priest. So Priest in the 56, your race leader from Suslin Harlow in the 75, Hearns in the 88. The three is Lobko, then it's Wharton, Taylor Hazard in the 70, Pope, Zemprogno, Fardle, and still Sargent runs in 10th place. So Wharton to the inside of Lobko now and will take fourth position. So Wharton in the 82 doing a good job to grab fourth position. It looks like Hazard and Pope are going to start mixing it up for position as well. They're running in sixth and seventh spot as they work their way around the top of the circuit. So the race leader, Oscar Priest, leading the way. Priest has been consistent this weekend. Priest, who won Heat 1 from Wharton and Montalbano. In Heat 2, it was, as I mentioned, Zach Lobko and Hearn with Sargent in third. And then in a Heat 3, It was Priest and Hearn who had Zambrogno up into third position there. So Priest, Suslin Harlow, and also the 88 of Hearn across the start-finish line now with 11 laps remaining. Wharton is driven up to fourth position with Lobko back there in fifth. As another kart into the dirt that time, it's the 8. Or is that actually the 8 of Theodore Lavanis. Priest leading. He continues to lead in that 56 Esprit. He set the fastest lap of the race one lap ago with a 32.398. And has got his gap out to 0.4 seconds. Hearn in the 88 runs in third. Closing in on Suslin Harlow. The gap across the line last time was 0.188 of a second. And in fact, the two carts look like here comes Hearn up the inside of Suslin Harlow. And Zach Hearn has made the pass. So Zach Hearn in the 88 now sets his sights on the leader in the DKS Race Engines Esprit. It's Oscar Priest leading the way from the top kart, the Next Gen Racing number 88. Can Zach Hearn make an impression on the Newcastle driver? So Hearn into the S's once again, the gap about two kart lengths. Last time by it was 0.4 of a second. I expect it'll be around the same as they come across the line this time. Yep, still 0.4 of a second, with Suslin Harlow now dropping off the pace of Hearn in the 88. Now Wharton has been caught again by Lobko, and Hazard is also right up onto the back with Pope and Zamprogno. Although it looks like Sargent just was closer than that when they came off the top turn. So not sure what went wrong. But Lobko now being passed by Hazard in the 70 kart. So Lobko in the 3, losing another spot as they head through the pit turn once again. It's Priest, Hearn, Suslin Harlow, Wharton, Hazard and Lobko, Pope, Zamprogno, Sargent and Harness now up into 10th position. So Taylor Harness trying to recover a terrible weekend in the 48 kart. Oh, bit of bang and crash through the S's that time. Lobko, Pope and Zamprogno all doing the bumper car thing going into the S's that time. Our leaders out in front, Priest, Hearn and Suslin Harlow, with a handy buffer now over Travis Wharton. And Wharton is pulling away from Hazard as Sargent makes the move up the inside and takes takes Lobko. And Lobko losing ground late here in the KA3 Junior Final. Now race leaders around the top of the circuit. Fastest kart on the circuit, just on lap 14, the third place runner, the 75 of Jackson Suslin. 32.320 fast. Now Wharton and also the 70 of Taylor Hazard tried to make a move then. Couldn't get the race leader. Oscar Priest still controlling this race, but you feel like Hearn is building up towards something as they come down into the S's once again, and Hearn has closed that gap. So the gap, which was 0.4 of a second, is now closing up to almost nothing across the line. It'll be 0.1 of a second, if that. Yes, 0.13 is the gap. Our leaders head up the pit straight once again. And it's Oscar Priest from Newcastle. Down the service potential pit straight through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip. And Hearn is right in a position now where he can challenge for the lead. Priest and Hearn pulling away from Soussel and Harlow as Hearn takes the fastest lap of the race, a 32.269 here. Zach Hearn in the 88, pushing Oscar Priest as hard as he possibly can. Priest leading the way. What can Hearn do? The penultimate time into the S's now, and Hearn all over the back of the 50. Wharton also under immense pressure from Hazard, Popes and Progno and Sargent, who are all back there looking to try and get. But it looks like Priest has done enough. He opens up his gap at the front of the field as they run down the surface potential back straight for the final time. It is Oscar Priest in the 56 who leads the way. Checkered flag is at the ready as side by side Wharton with the 70 card on the outside. Priest takes the victory from Hearn and Suslin Harlow as a card out onto the dirt. That's the 70 card of Hazard that just ran out of racing room there towards the end of the lap. More trouble back further in the field as Hodges and Hill are locked together over the start finish line. We'll give you a call of the card in a moment in this KA3 final. It's Oscar Priest who takes the victory from Zachary Hearn in the 88, Suslin Harlow in the 75, Wharton comes home in fourth, Pope is fifth, Sargent sixth, Zamprogno is seventh, eighth is Lopko, then it's Hazard who ends up back in ninth after he was challenging for fourth position. Taylor Harness is in 10th place. Then 11 through 15 is Hodges, Hill, Austin and Stocks with Fardell rounding out that 15th spot. It's Burton, Horsley, Hill, that's Madison Hill, Peter O'Brien and Lavanis in the 8 cart rounding out the 20 finishers here in the KA3 Junior Final.
BP Queanbeyan is a proud sponsor of the Canberra Kart Racing Club. They provide control fuel for all the club's major events and offer petrol, diesel and gas for your road car as well. With a Wild Bean Cafe, LPG bottled gas, car wash and more, BP Queanbeyan is your one-stop shop.
This weekend's racing culminates in the tag 125 light final. Pierce Lehane will start on the pole in the CRG Australia sponsored CRG kart. The four starting on the Tony. Paul Monaghan starts out of position number three, whilst Roy Sutherland out of four. Hudson Heath, he didn't finish the last heat after winning the first race today, heat number two of the tag 125 lights in horrendous conditions. Hopefully the 18 is right to run now, as the 16 Thomas McDonald also had dramas in the third heat today. Cody Garland in the 41, Tyler DeLeg is in the 35, Jared Payne's in the 28, Terry Hanley in the 12, Jay Hayden Cox is in the 21, Todd Stocks in the 13, Tony Webb's in the 26, Benjamin Ford's in the 10, Rinaldi is in the 98, Wishkiss in the 83, Riley's in the 9, Wells in the 69, Adams in the 22, Holden Stewart and Noonan round out the field. So still getting the carts into formation. Pierce Lehane caught out earlier this morning in the wet and slippery conditions when Hudson Heath was able to get past him and take the heat race victory. But Lahane has won both the first and third heats. Bregoni was second in heat one, and he was second in heat number three as well. Monaghan in the 95 has had a solid performance this weekend as they're in formation now, looking for a start. It's no start that time as Lahane and Bregoni just holding their line, but I think the problem might have been a bit further back in the field. So Lahane and Bregoni, the 11 and the 4 on the front row. Monaghan in the 95 and Royce Sutherland in the 59. Hudson Heath is the 18. We've got a cart trying to catch the pack, and that is... I'm just trying to get... Is it Sutherland? 57 cart is Holly Holden Stewart. We're racing. Lahane and Monaghan get the jump off the start. Lahane in the 11 leads the way. Monaghan goes through as Bregoni is in third position now. Further back in the pack, they sort themselves out as we got a spinner in the 13 cart further back in the field. So that's Todd Stocks who's gathering it up now as Lahane leads the way. He pulls away now from Monaghan, who got ahead of Bregoni there. Chris Bregoni in the Tony Kart number four. He sits in third place. Back then to Sutherland, McDonald, Heath, DeLeg, Garland now. Watch the 41 as he tries to move forward. Then it's back to Hanley, and Cox rounds out the top 10. So Bregoni looking to make a move through the Dunlop Kart Sports dip and towards the S's. Not close enough to make a lunge. No one really battling for that spot this time through the S's as Lahane pulls away at the front of the field. It's the race leader, Pierce Lahane, out by 1.1 seconds at the top of the circuit. It's still Monaghan and Bregoni, nose to tail, running in second and third, but just then a gap opening up between themselves and the 59 of Royce Sutherland as the 16 makes the move up the inside, and the 16 of McDonald has grabbed a position there from Hudson Heath in the dirt. So Hudson Heath there getting worked wide as he came onto the start finish line. So it is McDonald up to fourth place, getting past Sutherland. Then it's DeLeg, Garland, Heath back to ninth now as Hanley is, eighth, and Hanley's in ninth, and Cox still maintains tenth position. Through the dip once again, and this time it's Bregoni up the inside of Monaghan to take second place. So Monaghan now shuffled back to third, and he's got the hard-charging McDonald right on his back bumper. Our leader is Lahane, already out to a 2.3 second advantage, setting the lap record at a 31.904. The Galaxy engine working perfectly. They head down the back straight. It looks like Bregoni is able to pull away slightly from Monaghan, who has the trouble that is McDonald is going to be putting on him. A slip there in the In the 59 card, I think it was. Lahane slows. Coming off the final turn, Lahane has slowed, and I can't tell if it's a chain that has caused that problem or not, but we have a new race leader. Chris Bregoni is now leading this one. Monaghan in second. The stakes have just got higher for McDonald because he can see second place and first not much further ahead of him now. So Bregoni leading the way. His gap is about half a second back to Monaghan. McDonald is the next cart through. Then you have Sutherland, DeLeg, then it's Garland, Heath, Hanley, Cox, and now Payne up into the top 10. Around the top of the circuit, no change in this battle between Monaghan and McDonald. Right into the S's. Works Monaghan a little bit wide there. And that is going to allow Cox a spun. And the S's. But Roy Sutherland now is right on the back of Monaghan as they work their way around the top of the circuit once again. Bragoni is benefiting from the battles behind, but McDonald now with clean track is hoping that he can make a good challenge as he goes through the S's now. Race leader. Still Chris Bragoni. 1.2 seconds was his advantage last time by. McDonald now goes through 1.5 seconds behind the race leader. Monaghan in third position being challenged, yet to be able to hold off the battle between Sutherland and also Deleg in the 35. Garland then further back in the 41 cart, who's got Hudson Heath behind him. And Heath, oh, I thought Heath might have made a challenge that time into the S's. He had a good run of momentum there. Single file. Leader is Bragoni, McDonald, Monaghan, Sutherland, Deleg, Garland, Heath, Hanley, Webb, Payne is your top 10. Then we go back to Ford, Wishkiss, Rinaldi, Adams, Wells making up the 15, Riley, Holden, Stewart, Noons and Stocks rounding out the runners still on the circuit. Our race leader is through the final turn and extending his lead on every lap with half race distance now completed. Chris Bragoni from the North Shore Karting Club in the Karting World Tony Kart is out to a 1.7 second advantage over the Thomas McDonald CRG from Lithgow in the TF Race Engines CRG Australia sponsored entry. Back then to Monaghan in the Card and the Merlin Motorsport Trailers entry, who's under some pressure once again from Roy Sutherland. The Manning Valley Arrow doing a good job here through the pit turn as he and as they head towards the top of the track. Monaghan is not getting any rest anywhere around this circuit because of Sutherland and Deleg, who are working right behind him. As the leader, Bragoni now has completed 12 laps. One card off the circuit down there. That's the 41 of Cody Garland, who's trying to gather things back up. The leader around the top of the circuit out to a 1.8 second lead. So Bragoni benefiting from a good open racetrack in front of him. McDonald's pulled away from Monaghan, who in turn has started to skip away from Sutherland, but Sutherland closing in through the tighter and more testing parts of the circuit, and Monaghan is doing a good job in holding on to that third place. Sutherland, Deleg, Heath, Garland, Ford are your top 10. As they work their way in, Chris Bragoni running in second and Sutherland now. Deleg right on the back of Sutherland but not close enough to challenge. Garland has had an up and down race. He's behind Hudson Heath in the 18. A disappointing end. But take nothing away with five laps. Bit of a well and Holly Holt last couple, but certainly the nine of Riley and Holden Stewart are keeping him honest for the moment. Our leaders work their way through the final turn, and it is still Chris Bragoni out to a 1.9 second lap as, well, the Wells battle has come to its inevitable conclusion there. He's off the circuit, gathering things back up. And we see now that Aidan Riley and Holly Holton Stewart have got past, with Stocks in the 13 cart now starting to make his move forward up into 17th position. So Garland under some pressure here from Hanley in the 12 and the 26 of Toby Webb. Webb in the 26 is really pushing hard there in that comp cart, the two comp carts nose to tail, one from Lithgow, the other from Newcastle, Webb and Ford. And our leader heads through the S's once again. The leader, Chris Bragoni, is going to be able to take a nice points gap to the second round of the New South Wales Kart Championships in Newcastle. As the 125 lights head down to their final lap, it's Bragoni who leads into the S's now. McDonald, Monaghan, then it's back to the 35. Tyler DeLegge getting past Roy Sutherland, who's fading quite quickly here, and Hudson Heath could be a chance for fifth position as they work their way through the pit turn and up along the pit straight. Bragoni is well out in front. The Karting World Tony Kart is on its way to a victory as he heads into the S's for the final time. DeLegge and... It is Sutherland and Heath. Checkered flag waves, and Chris Bragoni takes the final of the 125 lights. It's Bragoni from McDonald, Monaghan, Tyler DeLegge, Roy Sutherland, Hudson Heath. Then it's back to Cody Garland, Terry Hanley, Toby Webb, Benjamin Ford, Anthony Wishkiss, Jared Payne, James Adam, Alexander Rinaldi, Aidan Riley, Todd Stocks, Holly Holden-Stewart, John Wells and Amos Noon rounding out the running order. Bragoni taking the victory here in the Dunlop Kart Sports New South Wales Kart Championships. Round number one here at Circuit Mark Webber, the home of the Canberra Kart Racing Club. We hope you've had a great weekend here in the nation's capital. Look forward to seeing you back here again in our next meeting coming up at the end of this month, as the fourth round of the Canberra Kart Racing Club Championship will be held at that time. To all our officials right throughout the weekend, a mammoth job to control the 4 days of racing here at Circuit Mark Webber. We thank you for your support, and we also look forward to seeing you at the presentations in about an hour's time at the presentation area.
Four three five five nine nine five.